So today we're going to talk about Aleinu. Imagine we started from the beginning of davening, and we've been online together for so long, we're already holding Aleinu. So Aleinu, here on page 80, is actually one of the oldest prayers that we have in our prayer book. A lot of the prayers come from Torah texts that are obviously very old, but as they are formulated into prayers, that came a little bit later. So we're talking about roughly 2,000, 2,200 years ago, something like that. A lot of the prayers from the Anshei Knesset HaGdola, as we've talked about, the members of the Great Assembly from the time of the Second Temple. But Aleinu, actually, according to one of the primary opinions, Aleinu actually was composed by Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' successor. So Yehoshua ben Nun, who we're going to meet in this week's Torah portion, again in a significant way. So Joshua is the one who composed this prayer when the people were about to enter into Jericho. So the people already are in the process of conquering the land and entering into the land of Israel, and Joshua composes this prayer. The point of this prayer is an acknowledgement of God, thanking God for making us the Jewish people, for giving us one God to worship, and for giving us the true faith of Judaism. And it's sort of a guide for the people not to be swayed or lured by the pagan gods and religions that they're going to encounter by the inhabitants of the land where they were entering. In fact, it's such an important prayer that that it said standing. We say it standing because it's one of the important prayers. And the prayer is about, if it was composed, in fact, by Joshua, there's an opinion that it was composed by the members of the Great Assembly, like others, but it seems that it was composed much earlier by Joshua. So this prayer then would be 3,292 years old, right? So it's almost 3,300 years old, this prayer. And in fact, you can find Joshua's name in the opening phrases of the prayer. If you look backwards, Aleinu, the Ayin is the end of his name. The Shin, Shalosanu Kegoi Aratzes, is the Shin from his name. And then you have the Vav, Anachnu Koyrim, Mishtachavim, Amoidim, Vav of Anachnu is the Vav. And then HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you have the Hey. So you have Hoshea, sort of spelled backwards, embedded in the text. As we know, many of the composers of the liturgy sort of embedded their names. They stamped themselves into those prayers. This prayer is one that talks about God, in fact, and the fact that we have the true faith. And this is a prayer that was said by martyrs throughout the generations. We know about saying Shema, that people, when they were burnt at the stake, or when they were giving up their lives for their Jewish faith, were saying the Shema. But another prayer they would say would be this Aleinu prayer. In fact, there's a report from France in the 12th century of Jews being burnt at the stake, and the Christian tormentors and persecutors and executioners hear the Jews that were being burnt singing a song. They were singing Aleinu. This is the song that they were singing, the song of Aleinu. So it's a very powerful prayer. It's at the end of our prayers, because as we're leaving the synagogue and we're now going out into the world, so again, we want to make sure that we remain true to our faith, that we keep that inspiration. Our communion with God, our connection with God, our conversation with God, that very personal connection we've established with God or cultivated and nurtured with God in our prayers, to take that with us through the day and not be lured and swayed by other influences and gods. Another point here, we say in the beginning of the, towards the beginning, we had also the fact that it's such an important prayer, we have it at the end of the davening, and of course we know it's a central prayer in the Musaf Amidah of the High Holidays, right? In fact, in the Musaf Amidah in the High Holidays, we actually bow. We kneel and bow, prostrate ourselves on the ground, something we don't do all year long, just on the high holidays. We do it during this prayer of Aleinu. So that speaks to how big of a prayer this is. And when we say here in the prayer, Shalai Sam Chokeinu Behem, that he didn't give us their our portions like theirs, and our lot like those masses, we say, Shehem Mishtachim Lehevel V'Lerik. They bow to vanity and nothingness. But we bow to God, the King of Kings, right? So when we say Shehem Mishtachim Lehevel V'Lerik, actually these lines, there's actually another line that's not in our prayer book, that's in some other versions of the prayer book, that was removed by the censors, because the Christians, who were the dominant religion and wielded all the influence over everybody at the time, all the Jewish people, they felt that it was a jab at their faith, at their religion. And so Jews were persecuted because of Aleinu, and they felt that it was taking it was attacking their religion. Although, as we've seen, Aleinu actually precedes, it comes before, predates Christianity, certainly Islam as well. So it's something that we've been saying before. And when we say Shalei Sam Chalkeinu Kehem, there's an interesting custom. Shehem Mishtachem Milri, we say when they bow to vanity and nothingness, so we spit. This is an old practice, and it was stopped. One of the reasons it was stopped because people felt that they were spitting at their gods, and they didn't like that. They didn't appreciate it, so it was misinterpreted. In Chabad custom, that this practice of spitting a little bit after saying Shem Mishtachavim Lehevel Lerik, that they bowed to nothingness and vanity, this practice was sort of reestablished, and it was explained that the reason we spit is not spitting at other gods, we're spitting at other people. What we're doing is, since we're mentioning gods of nothingness and vanity, we don't want to benefit at all from the saliva that's generated from those words. When we speak, you know, we start to generate saliva in our mouths. Because we don't want to benefit from that saliva, that's how strong our conviction is against anything that smacks of idolatry in any way. So therefore, we spit out that saliva that was generated from it. It's not about spitting at other people or anything like that. So that's a custom. If you see a Chabadnik spitting sometimes during Aleinu, that's what they're doing. That's this custom, which actually is a custom that goes back quite a bit. Okay, we'll continue the second half of Aleinu tomorrow.